So guys, let's look at this part. This part is very important. When I say, if I want to say that this noun belongs to me, belongs to you, belongs to him, belongs to her, I add yeah, me, kef, you, he, him, he, and her. So for example, here the noun book, kitab. I want to say that this book belongs to me, so I say kitabi. Kitabuk, your book. Kitabu, his book. Kitabuha, her book. Okay? If we take one more example, I say maktab. Maktab means office. So I say maktabi, my office. Maktabuk, your office. Maktabu, his office. Maktabuha, her office. Okay? One more example. Qalam, qalami, my marker. Qalamak, your marker. Qalamuh, his marker. Qalamuha, her marker. Okay? You will find many more examples here in the book, at page 60, so you can read them. Please go to track right now, CD1. Listen to track 43. You remember the word name? Name means in Arabic ism. So if I want to say my name here, let me write it for you. Ism. Ism is just three letters. Ism. Alif, Sin, Mim. Ism. Ism means name, right? If I want to say my name, I say ismi. I add yeah. If I want to say ismuk, your name, ismu, his name, and ismuha, your name. Here it is, guys. Ismi. Ismi, my name. Ismuk, ismuk, your name. Ismu, his name. Ismuha, her name. What is the meaning of what in English? In Arabic, sorry, it means ma. So ma means what? Ma. Meme alif, meh, meh. I just added before in one here, meh, and the question mark, meh, question mark. So, when I make a question like this, meh, meh, is me, what? What's my name? Ma ismuk. What's your name? Ma ismuk. Ma ismu. What's his name? Ma ismuha. What's her name? Okay? And when you answer back a question like this, if you are speaking about yourself, when I ask you, when I ask, imagine that I forgot my name. So I say, masmi. You say ismuk Husam. If I ask you masmuk, masmuk, you answer ismi Ahmed. Masmu, what's his name? Masmu, ismuhu, the answer is ismuhu Muhammad. Masmuha, masmuha, what's her name? The answer is ismuha Razan. Ismuha Razan. Okay, guys, so I guess that you have already learned the desert endings. Yeah, kef, and he, and he. Alright? It belongs to me, it belongs to you, to him, and to her. Okay? Let's move to the next page, page 61. And now we're gonna learn something we have just learned before. It's about hadha and hadihi. As you know, hadha for masculine,
هذه for feminine. I say هذا قلم, هذا قلم, هذا كتاب, هذه بنت, هذه سيارة. So if I want to say هذا قلمك, and I want to give it to you, I say هذا قلمك or هذا كتابك. هذا قلمك, when you take it you say thank you. Thank you is شكرا, شكرا. Okay, شكرا. Let's move to page, don't forget that you have to say شكرا again. شكرا. Exercise 7, this also on how we say that the thing belongs to someone. Number one, here we have Muhammad and Jihan. So the first word is مفتاح. مفتاح means key. Here I say هذا مفتاح. I don't say هذه مفتاح because مفتاح is a masculine noun. هذا مفتاح محمد. It means this key belongs to Muhammad. هذا قلم محمد. It means that this pen belongs to Muhammad. Bicycle, دراجة. Take care that دراجة is a feminine noun because it ends in ha. So I say هذه, I don't say هذا. هذه دراجة محمد. On the other side, you find the same thing, مفتاح. This is جيهان, her name. هذا مفتاح جيهان. هذا سيارة or هذه سيارة. Should be هذه because سيارة is a masculine or feminine. It is feminine. هذه سيارة جيهان. هذه حقيبة جيهان. هذا خاتم جيهان. And so and so. Okay, guys. If you have any question, you can upload them to the Moodle right now. Okay. Let's move to the next page. We're going to learn something. ممكن. May I have something? ممكن. Okay. So you can say ممكن كتابي من فضلك. May I have my book, please? من فضلك means please. ممكن القميص الأبيض من فضلك. May I have the white shirt? What the meaning of من فضلك means please. And of course you have to answer back saying شكراً, شكراً. A new word, أريد. أريد, I'd like. أريد حقيبة جديدة. I want a new bag. I'd like a new bag. أريد, I want بيتزا. It means بيتزا. I want بيتزا, please, من فضلك. أريد بيتزا من فضلك. أريد بيتزا من فضلك. Okay, guys, this is like summary for the adjectives and nouns and everything in the unit. Here, you can practice more the definite and indefinite articles. You can find the possessive endings, and you have some examples of words. Let's read them together. قلم, مفتاح, كتاب, قميص, كلب, دراجة, سيارة, خاتم, حقيبة, ولد, ولد, خفيف, قبيح, جديد, مكسور, أسود, ثقيل, جميل, قديم, سليم, and أبيض. Here you have a revision for ياء, كاف, هاء, هاء. So here is one more thing that I forgot to tell you. كا and كي. كا with فتحة, كا with ضمة. Sorry, with كسرة. كا with فتحة is كا. كا with كسرة is كي. The difference is when you are talking to a feminine, a lady, I mean, you have to say key, not ka. In other words, I say كتابك, your book, man's book. كتابك, your book, when you are talking to a female. So when you are talking to a male, you say كتابك, قلمك, مكتبك. But when you are talking to a feminine,
to a female, you say كتابكِ قلمكِ مكتبكِ. Okay, guys. Next one is when you ask someone about his name, you say what's your name? It means مسمك. مسمك. Here is ممكن when you ask for something. أريد. If you want to get something. Couscous, it's a kind of meals in Arabic countries. دجاج, chicken. من فضلك, please. شكرا, thank you. تفضل and تفضلي. تفضل when you are talking to a male. تفضلي when you are talking to a female. Okay, guys, this is the end of Unit 5. We are gonna start Unit 6 in the class next time. Please read the unit to get ready. It's about some capitals. Try to find capitals of some of the Arabic countries. Thank you. Don't forget that the other part of the video, I told you before at the beginning of this video that you're gonna have another video. It's a revision on Unit 1. Please listen to it carefully, study it hard, because you're gonna have quiz this Monday on Unit 1. Do your best. I want all of you get A's. I know that you're great students and you're gonna get A's. My buttocks. Bye bye.
Assalamu alaikum.